was to prohibit these children from attending school events during the regular school day or going on those field trips with the other children. But the children who are not immunized may certainly attend, for example, a play that another child is in at the school. It's a public event, essentially, or a school basketball game, or come to a public place. It is completely unacceptable to ban unimmunized children from public spaces. And a school basketball game, a school play, a field trip, a trip on their own to the Capitol, a gathering of other children outside of the aegis of a licensed school is a completely acceptable place for unimmunized children to be.
Thank you. Follow up? Thank you, Senator. Also, after there's a section, I'm trying to locate it now, that gives the Oregon Health Authority, it talks about them making recommendations based off of the CDC for further, you know, immunizations that should be put on the list. What authority, and I can find it if you'd like me to, in those recommendations, does that actually give them any sort of authority to mandate those? Or if they made those recommendations, does that just mean that parents would then need to get educated on it? Or the legislature would still have to take action to include those into the mandate?
Mr. Chair, Representative Stark, thank you also for that question. No. If the Oregon Immunization Policy Advisory Program recommended other immunizations for school attendance, in order for them to be included in the mandate, they would have to be amended into statute.
Thank you, co-chairs. A couple of questions. Referencing the public spaces in schools, I'm sure multiple of us have, but I have specifically asked that question of our attorneys in legislative council on the amended, and they have come back very clearly that people, students, would be excluded from those public spaces very, very, very clearly, including the state capitol, including sports events, including field trips and things like that. Very, very clear. Legislative council's opinion is that they are excluded from those. So we'll be amending the bill to address that to your testimony today, also by 1 o'clock.
Mr. Chair, Representative Hayden, I have not seen that opinion, and that is not my personal understanding from my conversations with legislative counsel. I don't have a written opinion to that effect. If you have a written opinion, I'd be eager to see it. But that was never the intention for this bill. It's unacceptable to ban children from public spaces in the Capitol. And that was never the intention. The intention is to protect children in licensed school settings and licensed daycare settings.
Goes so far as to say that Oregon students would be excluded from those, and students from out of state would not be, because they don't fall under the Oregon's law. So if you were from Idaho competing in sports, you could do that. But if you were from Oregon, you couldn't even attend the event. Second question, follow-up question. What is the CDC recommended interval for chickenpox vaccination?
Mr. Chair, Representative Hayden, the recommendation is to get the first chickenpox immunization at a year, and then, depending on the circumstances for a child, a second one either at around 4 to 5 years of age or at around 11 to 12 years of age.
Okay, thank you. In